UCSB Crew has become one of the major rowing contenders on the West Coast and one of the premier sports teams on campus. But how did this great organization begin? When did it happen? Who was involved at the beginning? And why has it succeeded after all these years? Here is the story. This production is dedicated to all of the thousands of men and women who, since 1965, by their support, dedication, effort, and commitment, made UCSB Crew what it is today. The earliest documented mention of a UCSB Crew team was in a sports column in the April 29, 1965 edition of the student newspaper, The El Gaucho. More than 60 men and a few women showed up at an organizational meeting on May 1, 1965 in Robertson Gym. This is when the UCSB Crew Club was officially born. Bob Kelly was hired in 1964 as recreation supervisor to start student recreation programs. At an October 21, 1965 club meeting, Mike Jeffries was elected the first Crew Club president and Steve Benson was elected vice president. The first year was the most difficult. Starting with literally nothing but some interested novices, Bob Kelly and Mike Jeffries managed to find a part-time coach, married grad student Gary Ray, who had rowed at Oregon State. Gary quickly established a race schedule for the newly formed UCSB crew and arranged with USC coach Bob Hillen to borrow one of their old eight-man shells. The loaned USC shell arrived in November 1965 and was an old heavy workboat which USC had named the Helen of Troy. UCSB crew renamed it, what else, the Charlie Brown. It was old, it was ugly, but it was ours. We had a boat. Meanwhile, Bob Kelly started an auxiliary women's support group called Shell and Oar in the fall of 1965. Always a working group, fundraising for crew was always their main job, but they did many other things, from helping build the training barge to driving the coach's launch during practices. A crew-sponsored dance raised enough money to buy eight new oars. Two were broken in shipment, allowing only six oarsmen to practice at a time. Later, we got more used oars from Stanford, but it was always two steps forward, one step back for crew. A place to row was the hardest need to meet. The choices were the campus lagoon, too small, the ocean, nowhere to launch and too rough, and Lake Kachuma. Kachuma was the best choice. The county supervisors wouldn't let us row in their freshwater reservoir. We tried the first two options, but rowing in the lagoon was not very productive for race training, and while rowing in the harbor worked for a while, the harbor master kicked us out when the shell foundered in rough seas one day during a small craft warning. By March 1966, we ended up launching the shell through the surf at Goleta Beach, storing it outside an old campus building a quarter of a mile away. I swear we carried that darn boat as far as we rowed in it. We had eight races scheduled for the first season, including some of the best crews on the West Coast. We won no races or shirts that first year, but at the San Diego Crew Classic in Mission Bay, we actually came in fifth out of six boats in the Frosh 8. We had beaten another crew. As Mike Jeffries said in his El Gaucho article a week later, we finally beat another crew and proved to the doubters on campus and in town, crew was here to stay. We were down to just over a dozen club members by the end of the year. Far from heroes, many of us didn't always know what we were doing, but we all knew it would lead to something special. The second year, 1966-67, saw many changes. We hired a full-time crew coach, graduate student John Caskin from England. Bob Kelly finally convinced the county supervisors to let us practice and hold a regatta on Lake Kachuma. Using an ASB loan, the club leased two new Pocock racing shells and two sets of oars. They were named the Red Baron, a fitting companion to the Charlie Brown, and the Vic, V-I-C, in honor of then-Chancellor Vernon I. Cheadle. With no boathouse yet, the shells were stored in the maintenance yard next to the park main entrance. It meant a mile trek each way down to the main dock area to launch the boats, but we had no choice. The training barge, a work in progress for 2 years, was finally finished under the supervision of Coach Caskin, and we launched it in the campus lagoon in January 1967. Shell and Oar focused on fundraising, mainly bake sales, sponsoring dances and movies, and one unique project, collecting blue chip stamp books that we could turn in for cash, hopefully enough to buy a third new shell. The 1966-67 season saw the first home regatta on Lake Kachuma on Saturday, April 15, 1967. We hosted San Diego State and Orange Coast College. The Frosh and Lightweights raced them at home, while the JV team traveled to Lake Merritt in Oakland. There were still no shirts won, but it was a triumph for the club logistically to manage two separate races in the same day. Our first trip to the Western Sprints, the equivalent of today's WIRA championship, was in Long Beach in May 1967. We still won no shirts, but at least we didn't come in last every race. Progress is slow, but was being made. Our third year, 1967-68, was another building year, but funding was still a challenge. Shell and Ore did their best with bake sales, sponsoring events, and continuing the blue chip stamp drive. Hastings Harcourt, retired chairman of Harcourt, Brazen World Incorporated, world-renowned book and textbook publisher, who had rowed in college and was living in Montecito, donated enough funds to buy a new 8-man shell. The boat was named El Gran Capitan in his honor, and he came to campus for the dedication. The county approved building an enclosure near the lake for storage of crew shells and equipment. The enclosure did not get built until the following year due to funding, but it was to be the start of what is today the UCSB Crew Boathouse. 1967-68 also brought the first race victories and shirts for all of the crew teams. UCSB had finally shown they could win. The following summer, several UCSB crew members spent their summer working and rowing with the E-Course Boat Club in Detroit. The result was that Mike Jeffries and Steve Benson were the E-Course boat that won the U.S. Intermediate Men's 8 National Championship. UCSB had made its mark on the national rowing scene. The 1968-69 season brought even more changes to the crew program. Graduating in 1968, Mike Tremmen came back to coach a novice heavyweight crew. This was a new West Coast concept at the time, but has since become the standard for rowing programs. The Meat Hooks, as they were called, beat four other crews that year, more than any team in previous years. In addition, the Frosch Lightweight crew was victorious as West Coast champions at the Western Sprints in May. The crew was finally able to have their own space at Lake Atchima, putting up a temporary fenced enclosure and a floating dock. Today's boathouse was literally built around those original racks. The ladies of Shell and Ore had always had a desire to actually row in the boat, a desire tolerated, sort of, by the men. Women's crew was not yet a widespread concept, but pressure from several Shell and Ore members resulted in them being allowed to compete in a women's four in 1970-71. The following years brought more women to crew and success in competition. In 1972, the women took fifth at the National Women's Rowing Association Championships, and so women's crew at UCSB had begun. They have never looked back from there. Over the years, several former UCSB rowers came back to coach the teams, and several went on to coach crew at other universities. In addition, several former UCSB crew members have gone on to be national team and even Olympic team members. The program has had its ups and downs through the years, but in spite of the challenges, today's UCSB crew club is more successful than it has ever been. Current women's coach and head coach Mike Holmes and men's coach Desmond Stahl have continued the tradition of commitment to excellence that was begun in 1965. This is also shown in the performance and conduct of today's crew club members. Those of us who were there at the beginning, all those years ago, and all the years since, salute the team and staff and congratulate you on the success of today's UCSB crew.